Hey guys, so today I'm going to be making a video about having romantic relationships as a borderline. So, because I have borderline personality disorder, and I think I have a lot of experience when it comes to like being in a relationship and having this disorder. It's definitely not easy. I'm not gonna lie, it's very challenging, because when you have borderline personality disorder, it's like you get very attached, I think, like in my experience. I'm not speaking for all borderlines, by the way, it's kind of just me. So whenever I say something, it's about me. But yeah, so like I find that I get very attached easily, and when that happens, it's kind of hard not to become dependent upon the person that you're with, but that's why you really need to remember that the person that you're in a romantic relationship with is not your entire world. You know what I mean? Like, that person is not everything. You have other things that make you happy. So you should focus on those things as well as your partner. But I mean, like, what happened to me was I was with the same guy for 2 years, and I loved him. Sorry, my mom just totally cut me off. Anyways, I loved him, and I was with him for 2 years, and that was a very toxic relationship. He wasn't the right one for me, like, anyways, but as a borderline, I relied on him, and I kind of, like, was very dependent upon him. It got to the point where I was scared for myself, because I knew that I was so in love with him that I didn't think I could live without him, or that I couldn't have a happy life without him. So I kind of based everything in my whole world upon him, which was not a good idea, because you know what? I'm not trying to be harsh or anything, but I'm only 19, and I was with him when I was 16 till I was 18. At that age, you know, a relationship is probably not going to be forever, because times have changed. It's not like the olden days where you, like, meet someone and fall in love and have kids and then stay together forever. It's not like that anymore. And the person you're with at this age is probably not going to be the person you're going to be with forever, and that's sad, I know. And it's, sorry, I have a bug bite on my face, so I'm just like, yeah. But I thought that I was going to be with him forever, and I wasn't. Obviously, he broke up with me. It was kind of on again, off again, though, sometimes. But I did not make things easy for the relationship either. I mean, he was kind of abusive in some ways, so I'm not saying that I'm to blame or anything, or that he's to blame, but what I'm saying, like, what happened. And, you know, I was with him for a very long time, and it was really hard to get over that. And, you know, so, I mean, I remember sometimes we would have fights, and I would just be ballistic, because I was basically that borderline that was like, I hate you, don't leave me, which is actually a book, but that was pretty much me. I did not want him to leave me, no matter what. I was so, like, obsessed with him. And that was my mistake, because when you become obsessed with someone, it's unhealthy, and you need to think about yourself You need to think about the things that make you happy that aren't that person. Because when you put all of your energy into one person, you're going to be disappointed no matter what. I'm telling you right now, no matter what happens, you're going to be disappointed. Which is why you cannot rely that much on one person. Because it's toxic, you know? You need to think about other things that make you happy. Like, you need to stay in contact with all of your friends and family. You can't just be with that one person, and you can't be so attached to that person that that's the only person you want to spend time with, because honestly, that is just not healthy at all, and bad things are going to happen if you do that, because it's happened to me. I became so obsessed with him that I was so possessive. I was like, I remember going through his Facebook messages and stuff and just being like, who's this girl? Like, who's that person that you're talking to? Blah, 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 blah. And I mean, a normal person wouldn't do that. That was my own insecurities, and yeah. And that really bit me in the ass. So the boyfriend that I have now, I'm really happy with, but if we broke up, I'm telling you right now, I would be okay. And that's the way it should be. You should never be like, oh my god, if we break up, I'm gonna die, like, there's, my life's over, blah blah blah. Like, it should never be that way, because that's when you really need to evaluate how much you rely on that person. And I mean, really, the only person you should rely on is yourself, you know? Which I haven't even gotten to that point yet, but I'm trying, and I think that's the important part. But I'm probably going to do another video on this too, because I don't know how much sense this video made. But anyways, yeah, I think when you have borderline personality disorder, you need to, when you're in a relationship with someone, you need to make sure that you are still seeing your friends and family and doing things that make you happy, whether it's sports or listening to music or anything. Just remember your life. Do not make your life his life or her life. You know, you need to remember who you are and stand by it. And just dependency is not a good thing. So just, it's hard, but if you think that if you're gonna be in a relationship and you're gonna rely on that person so much that that person becomes your whole world, then you know what? You're not ready for a relationship, because that kind of relationship is unhealthy. And I mean, rely on yourself. Love yourself first, and then love someone else, you know? Because there's a saying that you can't love anyone until you love yourself, and it's starting to make sense for me. So just remember what I said, and I hope it made sense. Anyways, I will post a new video soon. Bye, guys.